everyone, I'm Samira Parhizkar and I am doing a biochemistry slash molecular medicine PhD. Quite different to what I expected, not only in terms of doing a PhD, but specifically doing a PhD in Germany. So it's definitely been a while since my last vlog, and I just thought I would quickly catch you guys up on what I've been up to. Some of the major things that happened, some of the highlights during the past few months. Firstly, I gave a talk about my PhD in front of the entire institute, which was so scary. It was definitely the biggest audience I've had. And this was not only scary in terms of the amount of people, but the people, from group leaders to postdocs and other PhD students, technicians, like anyone and everyone could attend it. And as I said, group leaders, it was scary. But it was good. It was a good experience. Looking back at it, it was all good. But during that time, yeah. Anyway, the next time I'm going to have it is in 2017, so done that. Another highlight was I got to present my very first PhD poster at the MPI, and that was really nice because it felt like I'm taking first steps of my PhD, summarizing my first year. And get to present something. So it was mostly the PhD outline, what I've been up to so far, and heavily focused on what I'll be doing in the future. This may obviously change during the course of your PhD, but I'm still on track, so that's a good thing. I really enjoyed it. I really appreciated the opportunity to present something, and I'm looking forward to having more data to put in my poster. So speaking of poster and conferences, another highlight was the fact that I got to attend the third conference. The third conference during my PhD. The benefit of having a supervisor that is quite well known in your research field is that you get to attend a lot of conferences because it is hosted by him. So easy. I wouldn't call it a conference per se. It was more like a meeting because it was much smaller. It was much more intimate, which is really nice actually. I prefer it to having a big conference where there are so many things going on, so the information you take in might not be so much in the end, which is kind of goes against the idea of having the conferences in the first place. Another advantage of having a supervisor that's quite well known is you get to meet a lot of other scientist celebrities in your research area, which was really cool. It was super inspiring. On top of that, the location was absolutely stunning and sometimes quite hard to focus on the talks because as soon as you look out the window you saw the Alps like super close, and just behind the mountains was Austria, so amazing location. Additionally, during these past few months I've been doing a lot of thinking, not only for my PhD but also what I can be doing during my PhD to improve my options after I finish my PhD. The truth is, you know, right now I am really interested in academia. I'm very lucky that science for me is also like hobby, but that might not be the case in 2 to 3 years from now, you never know, so it's just best to stay prepared. So basically I've been thinking of a few projects that helps me be a bit more creative and gets my mind off the PhD as well. One of the things is actually these vlogs. Doing the vlogs have been a completely new experience to me, and it's been actually quite a lot of fun. It has definitely made me think of academic use of social media and perhaps even starting my own blog, which is daunting. Speaking of daunting, I am organizing a conference this year involving pharmaceutical industries. So this again adds on to doing something more creative, helping develop and improve my organization and time management skills, but also getting a fresh perspective in terms of future career. So if you noticed, in this vlog I've been mainly talking about extracurricular activities because I realized that it's very important to be involved in other projects that are not directly related to your PhD, but may perhaps help develop skills that you can also use for your PhD. And as I said, science can be, being in academia can be quite tough. And if you do it all the time, with the stress involved, with the pressure involved, with the competition involved, it will burn you out. And I don't want that. So let's see how motivated and inspired I'm going to be in half a year from now. Thank you for watching this vlog, and I will see you